Mostly, your Revit model is now cleaned up and ready for transfer. There will always be some tweaks to be done, usually with materials, but these can be done in 3ds Max. However, there is still one aspect we didn't talk about, and that's lighting and cameras. Both applications have two major light distinctions: man-made lights, or artificial lights, and lights that simulate daylight, sun, and atmosphere. However, we'll cover lights in more detail shortly. First, let's tackle the easier subject, cameras. Both applications enable you to create camera shots. Arguably, this process is more flexible in 3ds Max, but a longtime Revit user may not agree with that statement. Be that as it may, what you need to remember is that although Revit does allow you to create multiple camera shots within one scene, only one camera is transferred to 3ds Max at a time. This said, you can create and animate as many cameras as you want within 3ds Max. To demonstrate all this, we'll use a simple scene to learn about this workflow. It will be faster and make manipulation far easier. This Revit scene, named room.rvt, is indeed very plain. It has a simple structure made of a terrain, a couple of floors, and a few walls. A curtain wall at the front lets us have a peek inside. There's also a ceiling with four lights attached. These are what I referred to earlier as artificial lights, and they have a bearing on the workflow. At this time, you're looking at an orthographic generic 3D view. You'll add a couple of camera shots in the scene. Go to the level 1 floor by double-clicking it in the project browser. From the View menu, under 3D View, choose Camera. Click a point in the lower left corner and then a target point inside the project. A moment later, the camera displays what it sees. You can make further framing adjustments until you are happy with the shot. It's also a good idea to give the shot a name. This translates into a specific camera name in 3ds Max. Name this one Camera Exterior. Go back to the level 1 floor and create a new camera inside the room looking out. Name this one Camera Interior. Now you can switch from one 3D view to another by double-clicking the appropriate entry in the project browser. As you will see in a moment, only the active 3D view is transferred with the FBX file. Go back to the generic 3D view for the moment and export your scene to an FBX file. Name it myroom.fbx. Note, if you don't have Revit installed, a similar FBX file named roomcamgeneric.fbx has been provided. In 3ds Max, use import link to link to the FBX file you just created. Use the combine by family type method as you've done before. Click yes to dismiss the exposure control reminder. We'll deal with that shortly. The scene is now loaded. Zoom back a bit to view the contents. Obviously, the geometry is there. You can also see the assembly representing the daylight system. In addition, there is a single camera present, and this camera represents the Revit viewport at export time. If you select it, you can see its name, 3D View 3D. This is just a generic name since you haven't renamed that shot in Revit. The two other cameras are nowhere to be seen. Press C to see what the camera is looking at. This is certainly the same shot as in Revit, albeit a bit too close to the structure. Go back to Revit and switch to the interior shot. Export the file again and overwrite your FBX file. If you don't have Revit, a similar FBX file named roomcaminterior.fbx has been provided. Now use the Manage Links dialog to reload the scene. Notice the new camera placement. If you're having problems seeing it, press F3 to view the scene in wireframe mode. If you need to orbit around, use Alt plus middle mouse button. In fact, select the new camera and verify that its name matches the corresponding view in Revit. Again, press C to view the new angle. It matches the Revit shot. If you want, you can use shaded mode again using F3. Let's try it one more time with the exterior shot. Set the exterior shot in Revit Current and export the file again. If you don't have Revit, a similar FBX file named room-cam-exterior.fbx has been provided. Again, reload the file in 3ds Max. At this point, you are still in the room, but if you zoom back and orbit around, you'll notice a new camera named 3D View Camera Exterior. Press C to take a look through its lens, and you can see it matches the shot in Revit. More significantly, you'll notice that with every reload you did, a new camera replaces the old one that gets removed from the scene. However, a camera created inside 3ds Max is not affected or deleted at reload time. To demonstrate, create a target camera using a simple click and drag. Now reload the FBX file, even though it hasn't changed. Notice that the 3ds Max camera named Camera 001 does not get deleted in the process. So, what conclusions do we draw? First, camera creation is fairly easy in both applications. Second, and most importantly, although you can create multiple cameras in both applications, only one camera is transferred through FBX protocol. Which brings us to the other rendering aspect to tackle, lighting, and how it transfers from Revit to 3ds Max. This is what you do in the next movie.